hey, hey, it's the Pacific Northwest Geek here. Echo Blast that E-Man, Castle Grayskull will be mine. Kiro here, and I'm back with 31 Days of Halloween. And for day 12, I am looking at the 1985 movie, Hard Rock Zombies. Which I want to remember, I mentioned because when I got mine from Vinegar Syndrome, it came as a bonus. Oh well, it came with this movie here, Slaughterhouse Rock, which I did not like. I do like Hard Rock Zombies. Some of the reviews I've seen on it, I got the impression I might be the only one. But anyways, when the movie opens, we see this hot chamama hitchhiking, picks up two guys, takes them to the lake, strips down naked. Why, two guys, this one guy and these two dwarfs are on this side of the lake taking pictures where and watch her kill the guys. And then they on afterwards cut one of the guy's hands off. We are then introduced to this glam metal band. I know it says heavy metal, but it's, glam metal. I guess it's a form, like glam rock. It's a form of rock, form of metal. Anyways, after doing the show, Jesse, the leader of this band, meets Cassie. This girl, he, pretty much love at first sight for him. And she tells him that about some show he knows he has coming up that she doesn't want them to play. It won't be good. Anyways, by going to the show, they meet the, Hachamama, who tells them, oh, you can stay where I'm staying at. Where they, this is a mansion where they hear this howling sound. Ooh, shows them, that's her grandmother. She does howling therapy. The fuck is a therapy where you howl like a wolf, like a dog? Ooh, maybe I should take that up. Might help me with all the times He-Man's kicked my butt. Anyways, you come to find out the town. Well, some of the people in the town like it. There's a number who don't. And they even arrest them for, basically being rockers. Yeah, they don't like rock and roll! Whatever. Anyways, we go on to meet the mother, the and her husband, who was trying to get it on. The two dwarfs want to watch him. The toad, yeah, you can watch us go bow chick. We find out that, you know, like 95 years old, like, yeah, you can watch us, but no dutchy-dutchy, no dutchy-dutchy. And, well, they try to kill the metal, the glam metal band. It fails. And we also find out there's some, Jesse has some song he's working on that apparently he got found in some book, which one of the guys in the band seems to know nothing about books. Anyway, Jesse says this book, this whatever he read, can bring the dead back. Foreshadowing! Anyways, the messed up family goes on to kill them. And they have a funeral, and the manager is at a dinner with the family where he discovers that the father, the old man, he's not just a regular old man. Well, we already know the old lady, the mother's not a regular lady because she's a werewolf. But we want to find out the old man, yeah. He's Adolf Hitler. Apparently Adolf Hitler and his woman didn't die. And they've been hiding out in small town California. That's WW2. Huh. Okay, I guess. Cassie plays the song, the one that Jesse recorded with the incantation, and they come back looking like a bad Kiss. So at the face paint was a bad Kiss reject, and walking with the dancing, get their revenge and kill the family, who then come back and kill some town people, and now you got a whole bunch of zombies. Why, the band has zombies, goes off to play a show for some guy. The townspeople are freaking out. They think, oh, this is how dumb these town people are. They think that because this book says they don't like heads, they don't eat heads, that they don't like heads. So they paint a whole bunch of heads on some shields. Think that will save them. No. More zombies. Really dumb ones, I think. Then they realize, oh, wait a minute, if you sacrifice a virgin, you tie a virgin up, and at midnight the zombies will come and ravage her and then kill her. Jesse's gone back to his grave with his bandmates, and the manager has to bring them out to save Cassie. Oh yeah, during this time, my favorite parts of this movie is one of the two dwarf henchmen who's become a zombie is eating himself. I'm sorry, you see how he puts ketchup on his hand, he's all, puts a little ketchup, and he's just like, just, you know, got just a little bit of his torso, and he's just like, the last time you see him, he just literally just sucks his whole face in. Best part, most memorable part of this movie. I do enjoy this movie. I just wish I didn't have to, the only way to get it was that I would have to deal with this. You know, get it on Blu-ray. Come on, catch at least a version of this on Blu-ray with out this slaughterhouse crap. This movie sucks. Really an enjoyable movie. I gotta watch the special features because I really do enjoy this. By the way, one of the two dwarfs, it's a familiar face. Probably the biggest name in this. You see, he's been in countless movies and whatnot. I believe he's even in the first Troll movie. He was even in Ewok. He was in Willow. No, it's not Warwick David. If I can find a picture of him, I'll put it here. He's been in countless stuff and is a very familiar face. I would highly suggest watching this. If you can find it online, watch it. If not, I'll put the link for it on Vinegar Syndrome and Amazon. It is a super cool movie. I know some people will be like, what the fuck? What the hell? This movie is dumb. Dude, this movie is awesome. It's cheesy as fuck. The fact that they thought that faces, a bunch of faces, heads, painted on signs would keep them safe. And, the whole Ava, whatever her name is, Hitler's woman's a werewolf. And Hitler and her hiding out and letting people watch them screw. Bow chicka whoop meow. This movie is well worth checking out. Now I gotta go. I gotta go figure out how I'm gonna get that Castle Grayskull from He-Man. I will get Castle Grayskull He-Man. Evelyn. Evelyn, we got things to do. Don't tell her. I've been seeing Tila on the site. And King Randall's wife, you know, my sister-in-law. Anyways, I'm the Pacific Northwest Geek, and I will see you on the flip side. Toodaloo.